If you're like most people who are interested in the Corvair, you want to know what it can do in action, out on the road. You want proof that the Corvair can deliver the goods, give you more of what you're looking for in a compact car. And here it is, dramatic proof that the Corvair delivers the goods as no other compact car can. Years ago, in its early development stages, Chevrolet engineers began testing disguised Corvairs, began making the Corvair a road car. They made it a compact car with power, traction, and ruggedness. They put into the Corvair a suspension system to tackle the roughest road and level it off for its passengers. Chevrolet designers and engineers used all their know-how to make this 1960 Corvair the compact car that people could count on. But they didn't stop there. There was more testing, double-checking, retesting. Here at the challenging Lime Rock, Connecticut Raceway, the 1960 Corvair was really put through its paces, made to prove itself. And it did. It proved its stability, and then some. Just watch how the Corvair stays under control in this situation. Now, see how the Corvair proved its maneuverability and ease of handling. Some rough going. Look at that fender line. See how level the Corvair's body stays. Now watch the Corvair prove that it's got the power, the traction, the stamina to go just about anywhere. Just look at this. Using this stream for its highway, the Corvair actually plowed along like this for over 20 miles. And not once did its reliable turbo air engine falter. Now watch this sample of how the Corvair can stop. Slippery foam they're putting on the road. The same type used on runways to help disabled planes slide into safe belly landings. Watch the Corvair handle it. What more could they ask the Corvair to do? Well, just look. The Corvair proved its ruggedness in special crash tests. Not once, but over and over again. To see how it would stand up, they tried to make the Corvair roll over. It wouldn't. They locked the wheels, so it had to roll over. We'll be right back.